This video will guide you through the installation procedure for the SRAM Red Access GroupSat. View a full list of tools and supplies in the video description below, and review the user manual at sram.com/service. Install a charged SRAM Access battery into each derailleur. Pairing allows each component to communicate when a shift command is transmitted. Begin the pairing session with the rear derailleur. Press and hold the access button on the rear derailleur until the green LED blinks slowly, then release. The components can be paired in any order. Press and hold the access button on each component until the LED blinks quickly, then release. Press and release the access button on the rear derailleur to end the pairing session, or wait 30 seconds for the pairing session to time out. The green LED will stop blinking. Check that the pairing was successful by shifting the derailleurs. Press the left shifter paddle to move the rear derailleur inboard to a larger cog. Press and hold the paddle for multiple shifts. Press the right shifter paddle to move the rear derailleur outboard to a smaller cog. Press and hold the paddle for multiple shifts. Press both shifter paddles simultaneously to move the front derailleur inboard or outboard. Use the SRAM Access app to personalize your system's shift logic. If the derailleurs do not respond, repeat the pairing process. The pairing process does not need to be repeated when the batteries are removed or replaced. Apply friction paste to the inner clamping surface when installing on carbon fiber handlebars. Failure to do so may lead to the clamp slipping, which may cause the rider to crash, resulting in injury or death. Install the shift brake lever onto the handlebar. With the bike level in the repair stand or on the ground, raise or lower the shifter on the handlebar until the bottom of the molded grooves on the outboard side of the hood cover are aligned parallel to the ground. Alternatively, raise or lower the shifter on the handlebar until the top of the hood is at 7 degrees from level. Next, rotate the shifter so that the edge of the molded grooves on the top inboard side of the hood cover are aligned 90 degrees to the center line of the handlebar. These adjustments will set the shifter to the ideal starting position for ergonomic comfort and control. Adjust to your desired position as needed. Fold the hood cover back. Then tighten the shifter clamp bolt. Roll the hood cover back into position. Repeat these steps to install the second shifter. Prior to installing bar tape, make sure the shifters do not move or rotate on the bars when force is applied. If any movement is detected, loosen the clamp bolt 2 full rotations and repeat the torque procedure. Failure to eliminate any movement may result in loss of control while riding, leading to injury or death. Consult the Road Access Hose Shortening and Bleed Guide for hose routing and measuring instructions. Shift the rear derailleur to the furthest inboard position before beginning front derailleur installation. This will place the front derailleur into the appropriate trim position for setup. Position the front derailleur onto the brazon. Then install the washer and the derailleur bolt into the appropriate fixation hole, according to the chart above for your chainring sizes. The brazon shim must be installed when 5239, 5441, and 5643 chainrings are used. If the proper height cannot be achieved according to the alignment section, then repeat the previous steps using the higher fixation hole. Tighten the derailleur bolt enough to keep the derailleur from sliding down. Make sure the derailleur is in the outboard position. If it is in the inboard position, push the access button once to shift the derailleur to the outboard position. For the best shifting performance, it is highly recommended the front derailleur installation is completed using the appropriate front derailleur setup tool. Loosen the fixing bolt enough to allow the derailleur to move freely on the brazon. Raise the derailleur to the top of the brazon and tighten the derailleur bolt enough to keep the derailleur from sliding down. Install the setup tool onto the large chainring so that the tool is bottomed out on the chainring. Gently rotate the crank counterclockwise until the setup tool is below the derailleur cage. Lower the front derailleur until the outer cage contacts the setup tool and there is no gap between the outer cage and the setup tool. Rotate the front derailleur to align the rear guide mark on the derailleur to the rear guide mark on the setup tool. Hand tighten the derailleur bolt to hold the derailleur in place. Check the alignment of the front guide mark on the derailleur with the front guide mark on the setup tool. If the guide marks are aligned, continue with front derailleur brazon support wedges. If the guide marks are not aligned, adjust the high limit screw to align the front guide marks. Turning the screw clockwise moves the derailleur inboard. Turning the screw counterclockwise moves the derailleur outboard. Once the front guide marks are aligned, recheck the rear guide marks. If the rear guide marks are no longer aligned, loosen the derailleur bolt. Rotate the derailleur until the rear guide marks are aligned. Tighten the derailleur bolt. Repeat the previous steps until both the front and rear guide marks on the derailleur are aligned with the setup tool. This is an iterative process, and each cycle will get the derailleur closer to the aligned position. Once all guide marks are in alignment, hold the tail of the derailleur cage in place and tighten the derailleur bolt. Verify the derailleur did not move during tightening. If the derailleur moved while tightening the derailleur bolt, loosen the bolt and repeat the tightening process, compensating for misalignment if necessary. Rotate the crankset clockwise to separate the tool from the derailleur cage. Remove the tool from the chainring. Adjust the derailleur so that the tip of the tallest chainring tooth appears within the setup line when viewed directly from the side. Rotate the front derailleur to align the guide marks on the derailleur to the large chainring. Tighten the derailleur bolt. Use the access button on the front derailleur or the shift paddles to shift the derailleur to the inboard position. Adjust the low limit screw until the outer cage plate is directly over the large chainring. Measure the space between the tallest tooth of the large chainring and the bottom edge of the outer cage plate. The gap must be 1 to 2 millimeters. If it is not, then adjust the derailleur until there is 1 to 2 millimeters between the outer cage plate and the chainring. Then shift the derailleur outboard and repeat the previous steps for 5239, 5441, and 5643 chainrings. If the proper height cannot be achieved, then repeat the previous steps using the higher fixation hole. The front derailleur limits will be set after chain installation. Once the final height of the front derailleur is determined and the cage is correctly aligned with a large chainring, tighten the derailleur bolt or clamp bolt. Verify the derailleur does not move during tightening. Shift the derailleur into the outboard position. The wedge provides additional support for brazon-mounted front derailleurs. The use of a wedge is strongly recommended, as it will enhance shifting function and performance. A wedge is pre-installed on the derailleur. If this wedge shape does not fit your frame, there are 3 wedge sizes. Select the wedge that best fills the gap between the frame or brazon and the derailleur, without moving the derailleur. If changing wedge shapes, remove the existing wedge from the derailleur. Install the wedge and wedge nut onto the derailleur and lightly tighten the wedge bolt. Loosen the wedge screw slightly. Slide the wedge toward the front of the bicycle until it lightly contacts the frame or brazon. Tighten the wedge screw. Confirm the wedge is in solid contact with the frame or brazon. Confirm the front derailleur guide marks are still aligned to the chainring. If the guide marks are no longer aligned, the wedge may have been pushed in too far. Loosen the wedge bolt, move the wedge away from the derailleur, and repeat the wedge installation procedure. Do not allow the wedge to move the derailleur out of place. The shifting may become compromised. Make sure the wedge does not contact the rear tire. If the rear tire contacts the wedge or the wedge bolt, do not use a wedge. This SRAM access system is only compatible with SRAM XDR cassettes. For the cassette installation procedure, review the SRAM XD and XDR cassette installation video. Apply a thin layer of grease to the derailleur hanger threads. Use a derailleur hanger alignment tool to make sure the derailleur hanger is straight. A bent derailleur hanger will negatively impact shifting performance. Shift the rear derailleur outboard to the smallest cog. Use the access button on the derailleur or shifter paddles to shift the derailleur. Install the rear derailleur onto the derailleur hanger and tighten the bolt. Do not manually force the derailleur to move inboard or outboard. Manually forcing the derailleur to move can cause damage to the motor. Make sure there is no gap between the B-adjust washer and the derailleur hanger. A gap can cause poor shifting performance. Failure to size or connect the chain properly may lead to chain failure or cause the rider to crash, resulting in serious injury and/or death. Wrap the chain around the large chain ring and largest cassette cog with the flat edge facing away from the chain ring and cassette. For 2x systems, add one inner link and one outer link where the chain starts to overlap. For 1x systems, add two inner links and two outer links where the chain starts to overlap. Cut the chain. For a list of approved chain tools, consult the Eagle, Flat Top, and 11-speed chain compatible tools document. Place the chain onto the smallest cassette cog. Route the chain through the rear derailleur pulleys and above the tab in the cage. Pull each end of the chain together and install the power lock. Press the power lock connector links together. Check that the two halves of the power lock are aligned and properly engaged. Use chain link pliers to lock the power lock. Alternatively, rotate the crank until the power lock is above the chainstay. Check that the two halves of the power lock are aligned and properly engaged. Apply the rear brake and firmly push the crank arm down to lock the power lock. You should hear and feel the power lock click into place. Check the power lock by hand to make sure it moves freely. The power lock is designed for one-time use only. The power lock can only be removed with chain link pliers and must not be reused. Install a new power lock each time a new chain is installed. Reusing a power lock may result in a broken chain that could result in a crash. Shift the rear derailleur inboard to the second largest cog. Align the upper pulley with the center of the cog by adjusting the rear derailleur using microshifts. Press and hold the shifter axis button while pressing the shift paddle inward. The left shifter will adjust the derailleur inboard 0.25 mm, and the right shifter will adjust the derailleur outboard 0.25 mm. The rear derailleur may not appear to move. Watch for the derailleur LED to flash to confirm the derailleur executed the command. Shift the rear derailleur to the largest cog. Place the chain gap adjustment gauge onto the upper pulley. For the dual-sided gauge, place the tool so that the max 33 tooth, max 36 tooth side is up, with the top half of the gauge behind the largest cog. Turn the B adjust screw until the appropriate gap between the upper pulley and the tallest teeth of the largest cog is attained, according to the chart above for your cassette size. Remove the tool. Optimize rear derailleur shift performance and eliminate unwanted rasping sounds by fine-tuning the rear derailleur position with micro-adjust. Press and hold the shifter axis button while pressing the shift paddle inward. Use the left shifter to adjust the derailleur inboard and improve shifting to an inboard cog. Use the right shifter to adjust the derailleur outboard and improve shifting to an outboard cog. The rear derailleur may not appear to move. Watch for the LED to blink to confirm the derailleur executed the command. Make sure the rear derailleur is in the largest cog. Adjust the low limit screw so that it lightly contacts the inner link of the rear derailleur. Shift the rear derailleur outboard to the smallest cog. Adjust the high limit screw until it lightly touches the inner link of the rear derailleur. With the chain on the largest cog, install the chain gap adjustment gauge. Check that the gap between the upper pulley and the tallest teeth of the largest cog is correct for your cassette size. If it is not, repeat the chain gap adjustment section for your rear derailleur. Remove the adjustment gauge. The front derailleur must be in the outboard position to set the high limit screw. If the front derailleur high limit screw is adjusted while in the inboard position, it can permanently damage the derailleur. The high limit screw is reverse threaded. Shift the rear derailleur outboard to the smallest cog. Make sure the front derailleur is in the outboard position, with the chain on the large chain ring and the smallest rear cog. Adjust the high limit screw until there is 0.0 to 0.5 millimeters of clearance between the inside of the outer derailleur plate and the chain. Shift the chain to the small chain ring and to the largest rear cog. Adjust the low limit screw until there is 0.0 to 0.5 millimeters of clearance between the inside of the inner derailleur plate and the chain. During an outboard shift, the front derailleur will momentarily overshift to allow the chain to move onto the large chainring, then will move inboard to the final position. The largest overshift happens when the rear derailleur is furthest inboard. Make sure there's clearance between the inside surface of the crank arm and the front derailleur cage during an outboard shift, when the cage is temporarily in the most outboard overshift position. If there is not enough clearance, the crank arm can damage the front derailleur. Review the front derailleur installation, front derailleur adjustment, and front derailleur fine-tuning sections to check front derailleur setup, or consult the road frame fit specifications for frame fitment. After your SRAM Axis components are installed and set up on your bicycle, download the SRAM Axis app, available for free in the app stores. Use the app to create your account, add your components, and customize your SRAM Axis experience. This concludes the installation procedure for the SRAM Red Axis system.